just different.
I remember satisfying my night munchies with moon pies. Now I'm satisfied with counting feast days with moon skies. Guys that rise from ashes out of pure fire. Entire nation full of black gods having power and a black messiah. Christ, my God, ain't he the nicest? Slaughtered Egypt and Isis. That lamb became our sacrifices. Gave us the bread of life. And he became the manna. Taught us to cut with the word of God like a barber. No hand.
About stuff because you took, I'm glad you took the time to speak to my brother, because what he's giving you is information that we've never had our whole lives here in America. When we came off those slave ships, where is that? Hey, when we came off these slave ships over here to America, Jeremiah 17:4, everything that we had and knew was taken away from us. The way that we knew who our God is, the customs that we kept, the way me and you would have treated one another, the food that we ate, the way that we dressed, and the way that we served God. We lost all of that. And what were we given in on place of everything? We was given chains. We was sold, right? Now, have you ever knew that was in the Bible? Did you ever know that? Now watch this. I'm proof everything that I say out the Bible. This is what Christian pastors supposed to do. Watch, read what you got.
Jeremiah 17:4.
Read.
And thou, even thyself, shall discontinue from thy heritage that I gave thee.
We had discontinued from our heritage. Why would God take a heritage from our people? Why do you think he would do that? That's heavy what you just said. That's exactly right. Keep reading.
And I will cause thee to serve thy enemies in a land which thou knowest not.
Now watch this. Like you said, because our disobedience, what he made us do was serve our enemies. You see these whips on this man's back? You see these scars? You see our people step with yokes of iron on their neck? Sister being sold on the auction slave block from her children? That come from not keeping God's commandments. That's a very serious penalty for not doing what somebody said, am I right? You all right? Our mothers whipped us when we didn't clean the house. She said clean it. Our fathers punished us when we didn't do what he said to do. Boy, cut the grass, take out the garbage. We didn't do it. He didn't want to hear no excuses. He going to say what? Why it ain't done. And okay, you didn't do it. Now you're punished, right? That's what God did, because God is our parent. Give me Amos chapter 3. God is our parent. God is the parent of these people on this sign. Man, you need to listen too. You need to listen too, because this is for you. Read what you got. Don't listen to whatever you're going on right now. Don't even pay no mind to it. Read what you got.
Amos 3:1.
Come on.
It is word that the Lord has spoken against you, O children of Israel.
Now, God wants you to hear the Bible right now. He said, O children of Israel, that's the people on this sign. Right? Read.
Against the whole family which are brought up from the land of Egypt.
Hey, did we come out of Egypt? You know the story of Moses? And the children, the Ten Commandments, you remember that? When Moses led the Israelites out of Egypt? Well, guess what? Moses was a black man. The Israelites are black, Hispanic, and Native American people.
Bring it up.
He led us out of Egypt and did what? Read.
You only have I known.
God said he only know you. Read.
Of all the families of the earth.
Come on.
Therefore, will I punish you for all your iniquities.
Ah, he said, therefore I'm going to punish you. What's your name? Octavia. My name's Adiah. All right? God said, now we read out the Bible, we give you our own words. God said, if you didn't do what I say, do. He said that, read that last part again. I'm going to make sure I tell you didn't get it. Get it?
Therefore, I will punish you for all your iniquities.
What's iniquity? He said, I'm going to punish you for iniquity. Psalms 30:25. Watch this. I'm going to show you what iniquity is. That way you know, well, and when I go to church on Sunday, the preacher don't go into that much detail. He said, love everybody. You know, God is everything. He all colors. You know, you hear all of that? But watch this. But he take your money, right? Read what you got.
Psalms 32:5.
This is iniquity.
I acknowledge my sin unto thee.
Acknowledge your sin. Read.
And my iniquity have I not hid.
All right. It is iniquity and not hid. His sin he didn't hide. You understand what I'm saying? So we got to come out of sin, because that's why we ended up being scattered on slave ships from the west coast of Africa to all parts of the world.
Bring it up.
That happened to who? The people on the sign. And who's the people on this sign? Well, you see yourself on that sign now. Now we get somewhere, because Octavia is smart and she's hearing what's coming out of the Bible and able to apply what she's hearing. So let me hear Octavia say where she at. You got American, blacks, West Indian. Judah, Octavia is special. Now that I just told you how special you are and why we ended up in this. Don't you want to know that? Now watch this. Let's show Octavia why we ended up in the mess that we in. I want Deuteronomy 28 verse 15, and then we're going to go straight to sin. Alright? So I'm going to look at, you ever wondered how we ended up, like how they knew to choose us? Why did they choose Chinese people? It's like 80 billion of them. Where? Why did they choose Arab people? Because think about it. They flying Arab people, like 60,000 of them over here to America right now. They're flying American Airlines. They're flying right over here. No problems, right? But our people still struggling, huh? I'm going to show you why. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 28, verse 15.
Come on.
But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
Read.
To observe, to do all his commandments.
Read.
And his statutes.
Come on.
Which I commanded this day.
So he said we got to keep the commandments, right, Octavia? Read.
That all these curses shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
Now he said we got curses on us. We got cursed for being disobedient. So I got to be fair with you. God got to be fair, right? He is a just God, right? He is just. So what God tell you he going to punish you for something without telling you what it is you're going to be punished for? Think about it. When you went to school, the teacher said if you don't turn in your homework assignment, there's a possibility you will get detention after school. Your mother said, Octavia, I need you to cook the greens for me like I asked you. Okay, if you don't cook it, I'm gonna be mad. You're gonna mess everything up. Give me Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 44. Now we're gonna get what you're supposed to do. And then we're gonna find out if you, Octavia, willing to do it. Why? So we don't have to deal with this all over again. Because black people still in slavery, they just don't know it. Read what you got.
Deuteronomy chapter 4, verse 44.
Come on.
And this is the law which Moses set before the children of Israel.
Come on.
These are the testimonies.
The testimony, right?
And the statutes.
The statutes, read.
And the judgments.
And the judgments, read.
Which Moses spake unto the children of Israel.
Come on.
After they came forth out of Egypt.
Now he gave us rules when we came out of Egypt. You might know these rules. It's called the commandments. The Ten Commandments. Remember that? Tell me what commandment. Some commandments that we might be breaking right now. Give me some commandments. Let me see what you got. I'm going to put the mic to you.
Not
honor your mother and father. Absolutely correct. That's the commandment with promise. You get the death for that. Give me another one. No. It's not to embarrass you. And guess what? This is for edifying so everybody can know. That's why I'm doing this. Come on.
And we your brothers. Love your neighbor like you love.
That's right, love your neighbor like you love yourself. How you love your neighbor?
Like I love myself.
How you do that though?
I do for my neighbors.
You do for your neighbors?
Yeah.
Alright, I'm gonna show you how you love your neighbor. You ready? You should already be there. Leviticus.
I'll hit the volume button down like twice.
Test them. Alright. Check it out. We're gonna show you how to love your neighbor. The Bible tell you everything. Bible tell you everything. But we don't know. That's why we keep doing the same thing we keep doing. That's why we keep messing up. They got a man right now, look like he about to go right up in there and buy. And God said, don't do that. That's what preachers do. Preachers break the law of Sabbath with no problems. Read what you got.
Leviticus chapter 19, verse 17.
Come on.
Thou shalt not hate thy brother in thy heart.
Come on.
Thou shalt in any wise rebuke thy neighbor.
If I love you as a neighbor, I'm supposed to rebuke you. Rebuke means to correct. Like if I see something wrong, I'm supposed to tell you, Octavia, don't do that. Read.
And not suffer sin upon him.
And not suffer sin upon him. Now watch this. I'm going to show you what you're doing right now. As your brother, should I correct you? Deuteronomy 22 and 5. You're going to go straight to it. Hey, my sister, y'all ready? Y'all ready to hear? Hey, to let you know, blonde hair is a sin according to God. Pants on a woman is a sin according to God. Read what you got.
Deuteronomy chapter 22, verse 5.
Watch it.
The woman,
Octavia,
shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
Now watch this. He said, Octavia, don't wear what pertains to a man. Read.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
Now wait a minute. Maybe I'm being mean. Maybe I'm picking on you. But where that came from, Octavia? Read it again.
The woman,
come on,
shall not wear that which pertaineth unto a man.
Octavia, what else? What? God said, Octavia, not to wear what? Come on.
Neither shall a man put on a woman's garment.
Read.
For all that do so,
come on,
are abomination unto the Lord thy God.
Am I picking on you, Octavia? Is that hatred? I'm trying to help you get the kingdom of heaven. Now let me ask you this, Octavia. Now that we know that sin, what you got to wear for moving on? Skirts and dresses. Come on. See how easy that is? Now, that ain't hatred. My sister, you got to wear a dress. Watch this. She's going to dig his head. Sis, you got to wear a dress and don't buy on the Sabbath. God going to kill you if you go in there. Bang, look.
Bring it out.
You see that? She looked at me. Want me to show you that in the Bible, what she just did? Give me Nehemiah 9 and 27. My sister, you gotta dress modestly, sis. You can't walk around like that. They got men looking at your bed. They got bad intentions for you, and God got something for you to keep dressing like that. That's love. Rush this. She did this in the Bible. Read.
Nehemiah chapter 9, verse 27.
Come on.
Therefore, thou deliver them into the land of their enemies.
Come on.
Who vexed them.
Come on.
In the time of their trouble.
Read.
When they cried unto thee, thou heardest them from heaven.
Read.
And according to thy manifold mercies, thou gavest them saviors who saved them out of the hand of their enemies.
Come on. Hey, that's what we are here to do. We are here to save them because y'all here in captivity and save them from the hand of the enemies.
Verse 26.
Read.
Nevertheless, they were disobedient and rebelled against thee.
That's what just happened. She heard us and she said, that's black, that's niggas right there. They don't know nothing. So we're not going to listen to them. Because is the black man respected in America, Octavia?
Are we? No, indeed.
Octavia just said the black man ain't respected. That's why when my sister heard us bringing out the word of God, she ignored us and went in that store anyway.
Bring it up.
But I promise you, if that would have been a white man who said, look here, don't go in there, she would have stopped and she would have thought about it and said, all right, sir, and would have turned around.
Bring it up.
So we got to come back to ruling our households again. And the only way we could do that, sis, is by keeping God's commandments. So it starts with you. What you doing today? You watch your grandbaby. Do y'all keep any like church service or anything like that? Okay. Do you know what day you're supposed to go to church on? The what? What today is? So who you supposed to be with? You're supposed to be at a church that go to church on Sunday, huh? Sunday is sun worship.
That's right.
It's idolatry. God hates idolatry. Do you know that? That's the first commandment. Give me Exodus 20. And then I want Leviticus 19 and 4. Well, come on.
Keep it holy.
Okay. So how we do that?
Do it.
But when you have, remember I told you got to know the rules? And if the only way you can keep the rules is if you know the rules. You hear that, sis? You be breaking rules if you don't know them. Read what you got.
Exodus chapter 20 and verse 3.
Come on.
Thou shalt have no other gods before me.
If you go to church on Sunday, you worship another god. You worship Ra. You worship the sun god. You understand? You're not worshiping Jesus. Because he did it on the Sabbath day. He went out and healed his people on the Sabbath. Read on.
Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is above or that is in earth beneath.
And you ain't supposed to worship no other graven image. See that Christian cross? See that they had that in church? Talk about blessed and highly favored. What they say in church? You know Jesus when somebody got a cross around their neck. They'll be like, well, we know he holy because he got that cross on. That's not holy. In fact, ministers be the worst ones. They're the worst Negroes in the streets, aren't they? That's right. So what you got to do? No. The next step. Remember, I'm giving you the rules. The next step is repentance. So that means you gotta change. You gotta change. You can't walk around like this no more. You gotta be an example to these young sisters. Our young black girls are destroyed, Octavia. They in hip hop videos shaking their butt. They got fake hair in their head because they don't like the hair that they got up there, so they put white women hair in their head. They sell their bodies on OnlyFans and shaking their booties on TikTok. We need real righteous women again. You understand? So you gotta know how to move like a righteous woman so you can be that righteous example.
That's right.
Give me Judah chapter 8 verse 24, then I want Titus 2. Alright? We're gonna go back. I'm walking you through this because I want you to think about something. You never heard this information before. Maybe you have, but not with the understanding. It ain't been clear. You understand? But you hearing it right now. And I'm going to show why the Lord is letting you hear it right now. Because you have to change. If you don't change, your grandbaby's not going to change. If you don't change, your sons, your daughters, your cousins, your friends, they need to see the light in you. That way you can affect others around you. But you got to get you together first, Octavia.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. IUIC has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. IUIC, we deliver the truth.